Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, prospero año y felicidad.
Summer. Durmstrang Hall. Hard to believe it's over, mates. Harry was walking out to the hall with his friends, all with their trunks and belongings to show the end of the year had come already. After the first Christmas he shared with his godfathers and Charlotte, Harry had a blast going back to school and telling his friends the straight truth. They all had been true to their word about keeping Harry's secret to themselves, and Harry was more than glad to have them as friends, especially with Victor as his boyfriend. "Yeah, but we get a whole summer of fun. My family's going off to the mountains for a vacation." Devon seemed happy, mainly because his aunt just had a new baby and he was eager to see his cousins. "Mine's just going to stick around until the last week, but we have a sweet pool." Gerard was happy too. "I'll get my homework done, no problem." "We all will. Not like it's hard for us." Harry laughed. "So what are you going to do, Harry?" Harry shrugged. "Not sure. Mum's got a surprise planned, but it'll just be for a month before we come back, and then she plans on a birthday party for me before we come back."
"Yeah, be sure to send us some invites, eh?"
Nikolai patted his back.
"I will, if she plans on inviting anyone, that is." They all laughed.
"Look, you guys write, okay? I don't know when I'll write back, but hopefully it'll be before school starts."
"Don't worry, mate, we'll all likely be busy for the summer, but yeah, we'll all send at least one letter."
"Harry." Harry heard his mum calling, and spotted her at the front with the headmaster.
"Ready to go?"
"Yes, mum." He waved goodbye to his friends and strolled over to her.
"Have a pleasant summer, Charlotte, Harrison. I look forward to seeing you both at the start of the next term."
"You have one as well, Anton. Please give your wife my regards, and if the minister wishes to see me, he'll know how to contact me."
Yes, I'm sure he'll be looking forward to it. Now you two be off before the other parents arrive.
Of course. Good day, Anton.
Good day, sir. Harry shook his hand and left behind Charlotte.
I didn't see Victor in there, Charlotte said as she approached the main door.
He left this morning. The team needed him for practice since he's going to be having matches most of the summer. Victor had come and saw him the night before. They just stayed up late together and Harry let Victor talk about his best and favorite matches. He also said he would be in London for the Quidditch World Cup and asked if Harry wanted to go. Harry wasn't sure, but maybe he could figure out something with Charlotte to keep him hidden away.
You know, Harry.
Harry looked up before he could finish.
You know about the cup?
She nodded. Sirius and Remus wanted to go, but they didn't want to do so unless you would, and they did ask if you did they could disguise you and me.
I'll think about it. I already told Victor I would try.
Victor said he would understand if Harry didn't come, but Harry knew it would hurt him if he didn't. As soon as they reached the gates of Priet Castle, Harry heard faint running coming his way and then was trounced on by a huge black dog.
Ah! Sirius. Stop!
He laughed as the dog licked his face, but his heavy paws were crushing his chest.
Sorry, pup, missed you.
He changed back and helped Harry stand.
Boy, is it warm today or what?
Harry noticed Sirius was wearing a red button-down mull shirt and jeans with tennis shoes, and he saw Remus wearing the same but with a dark blue shirt.
You guys are dressed nice.
Casual wear, went out into town earlier. It's actually nice in summer. Remus hugged Harry.
Here, let me take your things.
He was about to move when Emerald the cat came up to Harry. She had been staying at the castle since she was still a kitten, even if nearly full grown. Hedwig had gone back the day before and she flew down to a tree and hooted at Harry.
Hello, Hedwig.
Hey, Emerald.
He bent down to lift her up and she nuzzled into his chest.
She missed you too, been meowing like she knew you were coming since 6 a.m. Sirius yawned.
Nutter cat she is.
Oh, shut it. Now Harry, let's get you inside and you can either do your homework or you can have lunch with your godfathers while I fix up the last preparations for our vacation tomorrow.
Speaking of which, where are we going?
Harry looked at his godfathers.
Might as well tell him, Cha. Can't keep the boy waiting till tomorrow.
Remus smiled and Charlotte laughed.
Hawaii. Well, it's a cottage in Haleiwa, Hawaii, but it's right next to a private beach with a beautiful cliffside view of the forest.
Harry's eyes widened. He'd never gone to Hawaii before.
It's also near a nice village where tourists enjoy luau's and games with the locals.
Don't tell me you own the cottage.
Charlotte shook her head.
No, it's a rental and it's ours for a whole month.
Your godfathers will be coming with us, of course, as will Emerald and Hedwig, provided they stay close.
Hedwig would no doubt fly around the island, but she would stand out.
Harry would have to ask about that later.
They will. I'm already excited to go.
Yeah, well, we aren't leaving until after lunch tomorrow. Gives us all time to pack and get away.
Now again, let's get inside.
They made it into the castle and Harry greeted Ignatius Portrait.
How are you, boy?
Fine, sir, thanks.
He sat down on the couch. So you'll be watching the castle while we're gone?
Indeed. I never really liked the tropics, too hot and buggy. He made a face.
A shame. You might enjoy the scenery.
An elf appeared and brought them a plate of sandwiches and tea.
Here, Emerald.
Harry picked up a small dish of tuna and trout for his cat. She dug into it when she caught the smell.
Your first real vacation, Harry. Excited?
Sirius took a bite of his sandwich.
Yeah, never really had a vacation before.
Harry remembered when the Dursleys would take trips for a few days at most, leaving him with Miss Fig, his neighbor, though at least at her house she wouldn't be as harsh, just make him be around her many cats and cleaning her smelly house.
Well, you'll be free for an entire month, but you have to make time for your schoolwork.
Remus pointed at him.
I know, I'll do a homework piece for an hour a day. Good enough?
Hour and a half.
Charlotte came back.
Deal.
Emerald finished her meal in no time,
and she curled up on Harry's lap, purring.
Emerald. Harry stroked her ears.
You and that cat.
Sirius rolled his eyes.
Down, puppy. Charlotte teased and Remus laughed.
All right, now we aren't scheduled to leave until after lunch tomorrow, so we have time to pack.
I've already got the essentials together, scuba gear, sunblock, first aid, guides, all the works.
You boys just need to make sure you pack the right clothes.
On it already. Sirius raised his cup.
Mooney and I went out getting some swim trunks and clothes, we're set.
I see, all right now Harry, how are things between you and Victor?
Good. He's off on a Quidditch tour with his team, but he promised to write when he could.
I think he will. She winked.
Now, Harry, I do need to tell you something.
She glanced at Sirius and Remus, who nodded.
I think now's a good time as ever.
Something wrong?
Charlotte sighed.
It has to do with Hogwarts, sweetie, next year in fact.
You see, there's a tournament that will start next year called the True Wizard Tournament, a series of magical contests between three schools selected for eternal glory. One champion is selected for each school, and in the rewards the champion receives a vast amount of gold, 3,000 galleons in fact, and wins the True Wizard Cup for their school.
Okay. Harry was a bit confused, but he had a feeling this wouldn't be good.
You will be thrown into it all, Harry, or at least you would have been if you remained at Hogwarts.
I don't know who or when, but someone will throw your name into the Goblet of Fire, a magical object that lights when the tournament begins and selects a worthy champion.
Harry's eyes widened.
Durmstrang will be in the tournament, and I will be.
Harry began to shake and his eyes began to tear up.
Whoa, whoa, Harry, don't.
Sirius touched his knee.
Just breathe, breathe.
You know none of us will let anything happen to you, Harry.
Remus assured him in a calm voice.
Charlotte has been working on this for some time now.
Mum?
Harry, I don't want you forced into this, but there might be a way to at the very least keep you from competing.
What way?
Well, whoever will throw your name in will put on the paper as Harry Potter, and yet your new legal name now is Harrison Priet.
Can't that keep me from competing at all?
No, because regardless of your name your magic remains the same.
Remus answered.
You won't have to compete, but there might be a chance you will have to be a backup of sorts if the original champion is injured.
Can't you stop it?
Charlotte gave a dry chuckle.
It hasn't happened yet, honey, and I won't know who does it until the event comes.
Listen, Harry, I know you're afraid now, and no doubt will continue to be until the event comes.
Harry stopped her.
It's not just the tournament. I have to return to Hogwarts and see those people again.
He shuddered, having to face his former friends and his bastard father plus the headmaster made Harry want to vomit.
Harry, you won't be going alone.
Sirius and Remus said together.
We will all go, and it wouldn't matter if they tried anything. Your adoption is completely legal, plus the minister has told me if we require his assistance all I need do is summon him. Plus my status as the minister's undersecretary gives me privileges of my own that can prevent anyone hurting you again.
All the men's eyes widened.
Undersecretary?
Sirius stuttered.
Charlotte had never revealed her job as a ministry worker, least of all a powerful one in politics.
You never?
I thought the Jehum woman was the undersecretary.
She is, and we work together on multiple occasions, though my position is for the most part is discreet because when Lady Jehum retires I will take over her spot.
That brought a lot of confusion.
We both hold the position, but Mystique has more power than I.
So you're her successor, apprentice?
Charlotte nodded.
Merlin's balls.
Sirius looked ready to collapse.
You know, Sirius, they are looking for more errors in law enforcement, but we can discuss that later.
My point, Harry, is that despite whatever they may throw at us, we will be the ones to triumph.
No one is going to take you away, and no one is going to force you into this.
People die in that tournament, Harry. It's not just games, it's life and death competition.
Harry paled and Remus swatted Sirius over the head hard.
Ow.
Nice going, Mutt.
Charlotte growled slightly and rubbed Harry's back. I can't do it. His breathing began to pick up and Emerald stroked her head against his hand. I can't do it. I can't. Harry, calm down, like I said, we have a long few months to think this one through. But if you can stop it, will you? His voice was hopeful, so were his eyes. We can try, if you wish. You have all summer to think on this, but for now we are going to enjoy our lunch and prepare for our vacation coming. Harry nodded. He did have all summer to think this through. He had to admit that it likely would help Durmstrang if he did wind up competing, but he didn't know what the tournament could bring. He would think on it later. Right now he just wanted to be with his family. The next day. Harry, are you ready? Everyone was packed and ready, and the Bork was nearly time to go off except for Harry, who just now came down with his trunk filled and cages. All right, is that everything? Yes, Mom, just got busy putting Emerald into her cage. Emerald meowed. She hates it. Well, she won't have to worry on it too much longer. Let's go. She pulled out a comb, and it glowed. They were transported into a beach house, and Harry's eyes widened at the ocean view in the front window. The water was blue and clear, the beach was pure with white sand, and he could see the cliff view in a smaller window towards the kitchen. The rooms were brightly colored but easy on the eyes. A cool breeze blew the trees outside. It was nice. Here you go, Emerald. Harry opened the cage door and the cat leapt out, sniffing around everything. Smells nice here. Sirius took a whiff. All right, everyone go find a room and rest up, because in the next 30 minutes we are going out to the beach. Oh yeah. Sirius grabbed his things and ran off upstairs. Master bedroom's mine. Charlotte raced after them and Harry just laughed before letting Hedwig out through the window. Don't go too far, Hedwig. He called after her, and then left to find himself a room. It was big, not as his big bedroom at the castle, but good enough. He set his trunk and rucksack down, figuring he would unpack later. Meow. Emerald came into the room and nestled herself onto the bed. Lazy kitty. Harry stroked her fur and she purred. And hope this trip's a good one. He missed Victor already, but he hoped he'd get a letter soon about his travels. He even brought the necklace with him, though it helped him know Victor missed him too. Harry? He heard Sirius calling his name. In here, Sirius. The door to his room opened and Sirius stepped in wearing a grey t-shirt and swim trunks and brown flip-flops. Ready to swim, I see. Yeah, Remus is getting ready too. I think him getting a tan may do him some good, though I wonder what your mum will wear. Harry swatted Sirius' head. Ow. I was kidding. Old Sirius and his jokes. You'd bet not let her hear you say that. He looked towards the door. This place is beautiful. It is. I can't remember the last time I've been to a beach. Hey, there's a lure tomorrow evening, and your mum said we can go on a tour of the village later. Great, that'll be loads of fun. Harry laid back on his bed. You okay, pup? Sirius sat down next to him. Yeah, a first real vacation for me, but. Sirius sighed. Still thinking about yesterday? Harry nodded. And you miss your boyfriend, right? He nodded again. Hey, don't worry, Harry. It'll all be fine, you know it will, with us behind you. He rubbed against his hair. I know that much, but still. He sighed. Hey, no sad faces on our vacation. Your mum went to a lot of trouble to get this place for us. Harry stared. Okay, Remus helped a bit, but still this is a time for us all to have fun and relax. Okay, I'll change now. Harry got up and pulled his swim trunks from the sack. They were a regular black with a green dragon around the legs. He pulled on a black tank and pulled out some sunscreen since his skin was still a good bit pale. You two ready or not? Charlotte's voice called down the hall. Remus and I are coming. Harry quickly changed and grabbed his towel. He and Sirius left, but Harry almost stopped when he saw Charlotte. She had on a one-piece purple swimsuit with a floral smock over it, big dark sunglasses, and her hair was braided. "We ready?" They all nodded. "Let's hit the beach." They all raced outside and set out the items under a good shady spot. "Put on plenty of lotion, sweetie, wouldn't want you burned on the first day." Harry did as told, and while he approached the wet sand it felt good between his toes. Sirius and Remus went out into the water, and Sirius transformed into Padfoot doggy paddling. "Are there any mules around here?" "Yeah. But don't worry, Sirius knows to be careful and we have a private area to ourselves so we won't worry." Charlotte leaned back against a chair she brought out. "You'll have as much fun as you can muster, sweetie. Here, let me get your back." Harry handed her the sunblock. "Don't worry, we'll take each day bit by bit as long as you make time for your schoolwork." "Hey, Mum?" "Yes." Her hands rubbed the lotion into his back, and Harry sighed. "How come you aren't married?" She paused for a moment. "I mean, you could be, but you don't seem like you need or want to be married." "Well, let's just say my past few loves weren't the best and I am not looking for love. I have you right now to worry about. My own personal feelings can be set aside for you." "You could though, if you ever meet the right guy." Harry Priot, a 13-year-old boy giving his 25-year-old adopted mother love advice. Where did that come from? "Sometimes we never meet the right person, Harry, but that's enough about me. Right now let's just enjoy the day. Sirius, stop messing with that shark." Harry looked and saw Sirius paddling at a baby shark in the shallows. It wasn't as big as him, but it wasn't full grown either. "I'll get him." Remus used his wand to send the shark away, and Sirius transformed into his human self. "Sirius." He whacked him. "I was just playing with it." The dog whined and Harry called out to him. "You play with sharks, you get bit." The two men climbed out of the water and over to them. "Who's up for a sandcastle contest?" Harry stared at Sirius. "You loved playing in the sand when you were a baby." "Loved eating it too." Remus laughed. "Sandcastles? That's a bit kiddish, don't you think?" "Hey, we're on vacation, we can do childish things as long as no one's watching." Cyrus laughed. "Come on, you and Char versus me and Mooney, the winner gets to pick dinner for tonight and the loser has to do all chores in the house for a day." Charlotte and Harry exchanged a glance. "You're on." "No magic," Charlotte declared, and they went at it. It took them all about 30 minutes to finish their castles, and to Harry's surprise Mooney and Padfoot's castle was better than his and Charlotte's. Sirius pointed at Remus laughing. "Mooney can build castles like you wouldn't believe. I guess we win." "Guess so. So what's gonna be for dinner?" Sirius and Remus smirked. "We're having steak and triple chocolate cake. No veggies." Harry laughed. Steak was Sirius' favorite food. He loved it nice and juicy. "All right, boys, let's swim a little bit and maybe later we'll check out the woods." Harry decided to let all sad thoughts leave his mind for the rest of the day, and so he went off with his family and had more fun than he'd ever had in the last 12 years.
Hello everyone, I am Matt1995 here with a small announcement for the video game fanfic plot. I know in every ending of videos, there is a small announcement that I will take requests for any fanfic or video game. That will stop right now. I have too much videos that I need to complete. There's sequels that need to be put up. I am sorry. For any requests that people suggested will be put on the back burner until I completed my videos. I even made a list of videos that needed to be completed. I am so sorry about that. Till next time, I am Nat1995, signing off.